and a warm welcome to the Cleveland Museum of Arts. We are so happy to welcome you to the beautiful world of our spring exhibition, Africa and Byzantium. This exhibition has been 4 years in the making in collaboration with our good colleagues at the Metropolitan Museum of Art. We are so proud of the work that our teams have done, and we are grateful to the support of hundreds across the world who have supported this exhibition. We are so pleased that you have all gathered here today, and this afternoon we'll be having some remarks from some of our honored visitors. By way of introduction, my name is Dr. Kristen Winmuller Luna. I am the curator of African arts here at the Cleveland Museum of Art and curator of the exhibition. I want to particularly give a welcome to some of our honored guests who were lenders to the exhibition. And here with me, we have representatives from the Supreme Council of Antiquities of Egypt. We have Dr. Ayman Ashmawi Ali Ashmawi, Dr. Fatih Awad Rayad Agulela, Dr. Mohamed Mohamed Youssef Morsi, Dr. Mariana Daniel Reddy Bashara, Dr. Mohamed Fatih Mansour Al Makawi, and Dr. Amal Mohamed Al Sawi Turki. We are also so honored to welcome the very Reverend Archimandrite Porphyrios of the Sacred Monastery at St. Catherine, as well as our distinguished colleagues from the National Heritage Institute of Tunisia, Director General Dr. Tariq Bakush and Dr. Muizza Shor. We are so happy to welcome you here to Cleveland finally after working together, and you are always welcome here at your museum and your home in Cleveland. And so we will be giving remarks now. I'll be giving a tour at, that's 4 o'clock. 4 o'clock, you can join me for a preview tour of the exhibition. We had an incredible slate of events prepared in conjunction with the exhibition. You can visit cma.org to get an updated schedule of that material, or my wonderful colleagues in our marketing team have provided that in our press kit. So without further ado, I would like to invite our first speaker, Dr. Bakush.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. I'm Dr. Bakush Tarak, General Director of the Heritage Institute in Tunisia. Let me start in the beginning by greetings to all Muslims for the Eid today, so Eid Mubarak for our colleague from Islam. And let me start to say that I want to thank you for the hospitality, first of all, and the good arrangement for our travel to your beautiful city. It's an honor for me today to attend the inauguration of the second step of the Byzantium and Africa exhibition in your prestigious Cleveland Museum of Art. This has become, after the first successful steps in Met Museum in New York, held in November 23. Let me remind you, please, that Byzantium and Africa exhibition is the first exhibition treating both the history of this empire and its connection with Africa. 160 artifacts, artworks, are coming from different countries, which 17 from Tunisia, and African European countries are disputed over this section. The first section, Late Antique Africa, explore the significant role of wealthy patrons and artists of this region in shaping late antiquity visual and intellectual culture. The second section developed an expansion of distinguished local Christian artistic tradition, and Islam and Muslim state becomes the dominant force in Africa at that time. The last section contains later work of Christianism communities in Africa, illustrating the connection between the arts of Northern Africa and Byzantium. Finally, this exhibition retraces the dynamism between two worlds and focuses on the cultural and civilization exchange during the ancient and medieval period. A cultural exchange, this magical world that we hope continue to use it and to practice it together, Tunisian Museum and Yuzer Museum, in the future, in a similar cultural project after this amazing experience. Dear Cleveland Museum Art Director, ladies and gentlemen, I hope that this step have the same successful experience that the first one in Metropolitan Museum in New York, and help visitors to be in connection with this ancient civilization between two worlds, Africa and Byzantium. I hope also that this experience encourages them to visit our sites and monuments in Tunisia and discover the richness of our land in archaeology in Byzantium period and before. And before 30 century of civilization. Thanks for your attention. My special thanks go to the men and women who make their efforts to succeed this exhibition. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Bakouche. Merci beaucoup à vous. And again, Eid Mubarak to those of you who are celebrating, and a very blessed Easter to those of you who just celebrated recently or will be very shortly. It's quite a month of celebrations. I believe next up, we will be having some remarks from the head of the delegation of the Supreme Council of Antiquities, Dr. Ayman Ashmawi Ali Mashtawi. Here you are.
It's a great honor to be among you today for the inauguration of the second step of the museum of the exhibition Africa and Byzantium. It's a fruit of a cooperation of more than 10 countries beside Egypt, more than 11 countries, which is something very important to show also the interest and cooperation between different nations in the cultural and heritage of humankind, and especially with this period of history. We are participating with 11 objects from the Cairo Museum, St. Catherine, and from the Coptic Museum. All this reflects the arts and the effect of the Egyptian art in this period, mainly with the Christian world, whether in Nubia or in Ethiopia, and reflect also the widespread of this Byzantine period. We are also welcoming you to visit Egypt and to see. This is a symbol, our object, to see the original the buildings of the Byzantine period in Egypt, in the Wadi Nutron, in our Egypt, Red Monastery and White Monastery, or in Alexandria, all over Egypt, to also to experience the original or the real buildings and architecture of this period, to have the whole picture of Africa and Byzantium, also the art and the architecture of this period, which is very, very interesting in Egypt. Also, I would like to take this chance to invite the visitors and the residents of Cleveland to visit our country, especially with the close date of opening or inaugurating the Great Egyptian or the Grand Egyptian Museum, inshallah, which will be very soon. We are happy to have or to be here and to take part in this exhibition, and also which reflects the harmony of many civilizations that raised on the Egyptian land and showed the coexisting and peace existing between different civilization, which we would like and we hope to continue forever. And thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Ashmawi. And finally, we will have a few words from the very Reverend Archimandrite Porphyrios of the Holy Monastery of St. Catherine and his translator, Eleni.
Ευχαριστούμε πολύ το φιλόξενο Μουσείο του Cleveland που μας υποδέχθηκε.
Thank you very much for the wonderful hospitality of the Cleveland Museum of Art.
Η χριστιανική θρησκεία πιστεύει κάτι που είπε με πολύ έντονο τρόπο ο μεγάλος συγγραφέας Φιοντόρ Μιχαήλοβιτς Δοστογεύσκι, ότι η ομορφιά θα σώσει τον κόσμο.
The Orthodox Christian faith believes very much in the words of Dostoevsky, that said, "Beauty will save the world."
Τα μουσεία λοιπόν είναι ένα κομμάτι αυτής της ομορφιάς. Όταν βέβαια ο Ντοστογεύσκη μιλάει για ομορφιά, εννοείται το ίδιο το πρόσωπο του Χριστού που είναι η απόλυτη ομορφιά.
Of course, museums focus on physical art, whereas Dostoevsky was also referencing the beauty of Christ and his teachings.
Αλλά τα μουσεία αυτό το σκοπό έχουν, να μαζέψουν την ανθρώπινη ομορφιά, ώστε να μπορέσουν με τον τρόπο αυτό να αντιμετωπίσουν το κακό που κάθε στιγμή αντιμετωπίζουμε όλοι μας.
But museums, by gathering physical art from across humanity, shows us a way out of the evils that can be in the world.
Εμείς στο Σινά έχουμε την τύχη να μας έχει χαρίσει η ιστορία μια τεράστια συλλογή από 2.500 εικόνες και από 3.300 χειρόγραφα.
In Sinai, we have the blessing to have
2.500 εικόνες,
2.5 million icons,
and 3.300 χειρόγραφα.
300,000 manuscripts.
Όλα αυτά είναι μια κληρονομιά πανανθρώπινη και πολύτιμη.
And all of that is a global inheritance for all of humanity.
Και εμείς έχουμε αφιερώσει τη ζωή μας εκτός από το Θεό και στη διατήρηση όλων αυτών.
And the monks have dedicated their lives besides the glory of God to maintain that inheritance.
Γιατί μέσα σε αυτά κρύβεται το ήθος το οποίο τα δημιούργησε, ο τρόπος σκέψης, το ήθος που τα δημιούργησε.
Because in these physical artifacts is the thought that created them.
Και αυτό είναι που προσπαθούμε να σώσουμε, που είναι πολυτιμότερο και από αυτά τα χειρόγραφα και από αυτές τις εικόνες.
And that is what they're trying to preserve, which is even more important than the physical artifacts.
Από την εποχή του Ιουστινιανού τον 5ο αιώνα,
from the time of Justinian in the 5th century,
η Σιναϊτική αδελφότητα της οποίας έχω την τιμή να είμαι μέλος,
the community in Sinai which he has the blessing to be a part of,
πορεύεται χωρίς διακοπή μέσα στις δυσκολίες της ιστορίας.
Has journeyed without any kind of break throughout history. They are a continuous monastery.
Σκορπώντας το φως της ειρήνης, της συναδέλφωσης και της αγάπης.
And spreading the light of peace, cooperation and love.
Αυτό φέραμε λοιπόν εδώ στο Cleveland μαζί με τα ιερά κοιμήλια μας.
And that is what we brought to Cleveland along with the artifacts.
Σας ευχαριστούμε πάρα πολύ για την φιλοξενία.
Thank you very much for the hospitality.
Και ελπίζω ο κόπος του μουσείου και ο κόπος όλων μας να μην πάει χαμένος, αλλά να είναι ένα λιθαράκι στην οικοδόμηση μιας αγάπης προς την ομορφιά.
And the efforts here can be one part of expanding beauty and understanding.
Πολλά συγχαρητήρια στους διοργανωτές και καλή επιτυχία στην έκθεση.
Congratulations to the organizers and best of luck for the exhibit.
Ευχαριστώ πολύ, Αγγελίνα Πορφύριος, and thank you to all. That marks the conclusion of our remarks section. You are free to wander the galleries as you like and to meet me back here for a tour at 4 p.m. So looking forward to seeing you all again, and thank you.